السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Hi my dear students, happy new academic year. I hope you are well and you have enjoyed your vacation, and please keep safe as possible. This course is speaking about total quality management. My name is Samara Dfam. This is the first lecture in this course. This course is directed to the fourth year students, Business Administration Department, English Section, Faculty of Commerce, Kafr Sheikh University. I hope you enjoy studying this course with me. As this is the first lecture in this course, TQM, Total Quality Management, so I prefer to begin it by providing a hint or brief introduction about what is the meaning of quality, what is the total quality concept means, what are the benefits that companies will gain from pursuing or applying or matching to total quality concepts, and how the quality concept is processed in both of manufacturing and service sectors. Is there any difference between both sectors? Of course, there are some differences between manufacturing and service sectors, and of course these differences in producing a product or delivering a service of course has its impact on the way of applying or matching to quality concept in both sectors. So all of these issues or all of these items we need to know and understand it or discuss through our lecture today. So let's go to the next slide. The first questions we wanted to answer today is, what is the total quality, TQ? As you see in the slide, TQ is a comprehensive organization-wide effort to improve the quality of products and service, and this is applies to all organizations, whatever it is, whatever they are, large or small, working in manufacturing or service sector, working for attaining a profit, or they are non-profit organizations. So total quality is effort done by all types of organizations, different types of organizations, whatever providing products or service, whatever the type of organization. This leads us to another question, or to think about an issue. How different organizations, different in size, different in sector, different in type of industry, how, despite of their differences, think about the same thing. Think about total quality. How they, all of them, think about total quality. So of course, thinking in total quality or pursuing total quality by organizations will attain many benefits for companies that pursue total quality. So what are these benefits? As we see also on the slide, these benefits can be mentioned in 4 points: improving performance, and the measure their performance on the basis of the income. If the income increased, so this means that their performance has improved. Also, another benefit is growing and increasing sales. As I said before, if performance improved, so this means that income increased, and income, how income increased? Income increased from increasing or growing sales. Also, controlling costs, because when a company pursue TQM or try to produce its product or provide or deliver its service according to standards, so this means that it will check all process or production process or all process of delivering service. So checking a process will result in controlling costs and reducing or delaying or preventing any waste, which can result in increasing costs. Number four, growing employment and total assets. Of course, when sales increased, So this means that there is high demand on the products provided or produced by this company. So this means that they need to recruit another employees or employ increasing their employment rates because they need more human resources, and also this means that increasing their assets. One of the things that I want to mention is we seldom hear nowadays about quality in business, except when things go wrong. I mean that when there is a problem with a customer related to quality, so customer begin, what about the quality of this product? It is not matching the standards you mentioned, and for example, on the package of your product. So we hear about the word quality when there is a problem. However, if there is no problem, customers not speak about quality. So this means that quality or companies also, why companies, this one is the thing that I want to mention, why companies think about quality, not only just because the benefits that can company gain from pursuing total quality, but also in order to attain customer satisfaction, to make its customers cheerful and happy, satisfied about the product or service it provided to them. This reason to pursue total quality is not only mentioned by companies or managers, but also it is stated by the American National Standards Institute, ANSI, and the American Society for Quality, ASQ, in their definitions for the quality, as they define it as the totality of features and characteristics of a product or service that bears on its ability to satisfy given needs. This view of quality and satisfaction of customer needs is often called fitness for use. However, in competitively markets, merely satisfying customer needs is not enough to achieve success, because they want or they must exceed customer expectations. So the main reason to pursue quality is not only to satisfy customers or achieve their needs and wants, but to exceed, is not only meeting their needs and wants or their expectation, but to exceed, provide more about these expectations in order to beat your competitor in the market.